The last of three games today at Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, the Class 2A Division I state championship between the Daingerfield Tigers and the Yeomen of Cameron Yeo. Great to have you with us on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Alongside LaDarren McClain, I'm Doug Anderson. And LD, what a way to wrap up the 2010 football season. The Daingerfield Tigers going for a three-peat in Class 2A.
Well, if you look at the Cameron Yeomen, they've got a storied program as well. And they've come out here and got a chance tonight to prove themselves. And it comes down to one game to take it all.
Let's take a look at our key players in the ball game tonight, and we start with the Yeomen, their quarterback, Jack Rhodes, first-team All-State in Class 2A.
He's had an impressive season this year, 46 touchdowns on the year. He's got to be effective against a very aggressive defense in the Daingerfield Tigers. I look for him to get hot early.
You talk about aggressive defense. The guy that leads the defense for the Daingerfield Tigers is the 2A Defensive Player of the Year, linebacker Steve Edmond.
He's on his way to play for the University of Texas next fall. This guy is going to be all over the field, and for the Yeomen, they've got to get him blocked because he is a tackling machine.
Great coaches matching up in this ball game. For Cameron Yeo, it's the dad of Jack Rhodes. We're talking about Rick Rhodes, who in his time at Cameron Yeo has put together a great team in just 2 years. He took New Braunfels to the 4A Division II title game in 2002. And Barry Bowman for the Daingerfield Tigers in his third season, going for a third state championship, and he is doing a fantastic job with Daingerfield. So it should be a great matchup between the two coaches and between the two teams. And we'll kick it off from Mansfield in a moment right here on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Ready for the nightcap at Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, the 2A Division I state championship. And this is the marquee matchup of the four games that we've seen this weekend here in Mansfield. Daingerfield's Tigers, 13-1, and looking for a three-peat in Class 2A, taking on the 14-0 Yeomen of Cameron Yeo, a team that has not won a state championship since 1981. But certainly one of the top teams in the state of Texas this year. And LD, when you look at the tradition between these two teams, Cameron Yeo, they may not have won a state championship since 81, but traditionally they're one of the winningest programs in all of Central Texas. And then you take an East Texas powerhouse like Daingerfield and put them up against them, and that's a heavyweight fight right there.
Yeah, at some point something's got to give. And really, one of these teams here tonight, it's going to come down to which team can get the adrenaline rush and get past that and execute the game plan. I think that's what it's going to come down to. These teams are evenly matched. Which team is going to make the least mistakes is going to be the victor today.
The Yeomen will kick to start the game wearing white jerseys and gray pants. And Daingerfield in their blue jerseys with white pants and white helmets with the stylized D on the helmet. Of course, the Yeomen with the very famous helmet with the big Y and the O and E on the sides. So it looks like Oye instead of Yo.
That's a good look nonetheless. Both of these teams having pretty good outfits here tonight.
Tyler Boyd is the dual threat quarterback that leads the Daingerfield offense. Number 13, 2,300 yards passing and 39 touchdowns this year, 844 yards on the ground and 17 TDs. Boyd wants to go deep. First play of the game, has a wide open man downfield, caught at the 40-yard line, makes a move inside the 20 and gone to the end zone is Darren Terry for an 82-yard touchdown on the first play of the game.
Time you come in and try to open up this state championship. You strike blood first. That's the one thing that you had to have a concern in, and you cannot give this quarterback that much time to throw. These receivers on the outside have blazing speed. Nobody's been able to match up with them on the outside, and that's the one thing. You cannot let these guys get in behind you. Even though that pass was on the throw, Darren Terry did an excellent job of adjusting, turning that into a touchdown.
Steve Edmond, the All-State linebacker, does the kicking honors for the extra point, and it's good. 7-0 The Tigers, 13 seconds into the game, lead it by a touchdown. Get a good look at Steve Edmond there, 6'3", 235 pounds, the All-State linebacker, heading to the University of Texas. He also does a little kicking for the Daingerfield Tigers, made the extra point to make it 7-0. Daingerfield scoring on the first play of the game, an 82-yard pass from Tyler Boyd to Darren Terry, his fourth touchdown reception of the year, and for Tyler Boyd, his 40th touchdown pass of the season.
Now, that was a thing of beauty, and they caught this defense sleeping, literally. Caught them sleeping, no play-action pass, just a straight go routes on the outside, and they benefited from it big time.
Quinn Haynes will take the kick, fake the reverse, and he has running room down the right side, across the 40, and taken down by Edmond. And around the 44-yard line, a 25-yard return, and he met a freight train named Steve Edmond on that return. And I think he's fortunate to come away with that one unscathed.
Well, I like the call here. Fake the reverse, get out in front, but you got to look out for the one of the biggest guys on the field. He delivers a blow. That sets up pretty decent field position here for the Yeoman offense, and an offense that's awfully good led by their quarterback.
Well, we didn't get a chance to even introduce the Daingerfield offense, really. We'll try to do that with Cameron Yeo, as the Yeomen are led by their senior quarterback, Jack Rhodes, the son of head coach Rick Rhodes, 6'3", 175 pounds, 3,300 passing yards, and 46 touchdowns this year. Delivers it to Haynes. Quinn Haynes showing you some speed as he works his way to the 45-yard line. A first down, 12-yard pickup for the Yeoman. The offensive line left to right, Inez Rangel, Basilio Montez, Jacob Kaustrin, Ray Rangel, and Josh Smitherman. The running back is Damian Kelly. The receivers, Thomas Wren, Zach Brashear, Derek Westbrook, and Quinn Derrick, or otherwise known as Quinn Haynes, number one. An offense that averages 44 points a game and puts up almost 400 yards of offense a game. Penalty flag. Damian Kelly on the run picks up the first down to about the 31-yard line, but we'll see if the play stands after the flag.
I think that's going to be a neutral zone infraction there by the Tigers.
Defense, that penalty's declined. First down.
That is our referee, Dan Carroll. His crew comes from the Dallas chapter of the Texas Association of Sports Officials. Certainly appreciate them being here tonight. And they should be in store for a very good ball game.
Now, right now, I'm impressed with the speed of the game. You saw right off the bat the Tigers striking first. Pretty impressed here by the Yoke. They've got some guys that can get out in front and run, too.
Kelly takes the handoff, taken down. In the backfield by Shavion Hatton. Big number 70, Shavion Hatton is committed to TCU, 6'5", 280-pound senior who plays on the offensive and defensive line.
And it's really going to be a situation, where do you play him? But I think you can put him anywhere. That's a fine play. He sheds that block, locates the ball immediately, makes that tackle in the backfield.
That looked like cat and mouse. Hatton the big cat and Damian Kelly the little mouse at 5'5", 160.
Didn't look fair, did it?
Pass to Haynes, and Haynes is wrapped up and dropped for a loss. Boy, David Mims got up there in a hurry and made the tackle on Haynes. And you talk about speed, Daingerfield's got it with plenty to spare.
Yeah, but they don't have the depth like we've accustomed to see them in their state title run, but they've got the talent. And you look at this kid here, David Mims, he's in a terrific cover corner. Now, this guy can do it all, but you saw there coming up and making the play and the tackle, that's where they need him most.
Third and 15. Rhodes out of the shotgun, has two receivers to the near side, two men split on the right. Pass underneath the Quinn Haynes, and he goes down as he was tackled by Aaron Lewis. Well shy of a first down. That only picked up a couple of yards.
These guys are tackling machines, and you see a lot of man coverage because the speed is so great in the secondary. Pretty good pressure there. Nice job there by Roach to step up and locate a receiver, but there's the defense there on the spot. An open field tackle there by Lewis.
In addition to being a first-team All-State quarterback, Jack Roach is also the first-team All-State punter. Averaged 43.9. We'll see him try to kick one significantly shorter this time as he tries to play the field position game and does a pretty good job of it, stopping that ball on the 12-yard line. So Rhodes pins Daingerfield inside their own territory at the 12. That didn't seem to matter on the last drive as they went 82 yards on one play.
No, and it's not going to matter the rest of the night. They can't get pressure back there on Tyler Boyd. And I watched him doing warm-ups. He's got a cannon. He's pretty accurate. And this offensive line right now, with just one play now, did a perfect job of pass protection.
Tyler Boyd is the quarterback. You know about him. How about the offensive line? Shavion Hatton, Adante Lewis, who was a first-team All-State offensive lineman, Jacoby Peters, Donald Bryant, and John Smith across that front line. Penalty flag. False start coming against the Tigers. The running back is Lamar Lafayette, who has 1,400 yards.
5 yards. We play first down.
And 11 touchdowns on the season. The receivers, Kyaris Garrett, a 6'5 senior who's committed to Tulsa, Jeremy Godbolt, Darren Terry, and Edwin Mims.
Now we've seen what Darren Terry can do out in man coverage, and I think this kid right here is benefited from these bigger, taller, and faster receivers on the outside matched up man-to-man against the smaller defensive backs.
Tyler Boyd on the run. Across the 10 up to about the 15-yard line. Picks up 8 yards on the carry. And that's the dual threat of Tyler Boyd. He can throw the ball, as we saw on that 82-yard scoring strike, but he can also run with the ball, coming close to a 1,000-yard season.
And it's a little bit of different situation in the games we've seen before. We've seen the quarterbacks be able to run to keep the defense honest. I think this is different in the fact that Boyd is a quarterback that is a threat, a legitimate threat that can go the distance on any play.
Jack Rhodes was first-team All-State. Tyler Boyd, second-team All-State. And he shows you why as he delivers to his big man, Kyaris Garrett, for a first down.
Kyaris just using that big body, Doug, just getting inside of the defense, and they're playing zone, and it's an easy target there for Tyler Boyd. And you really got to like the look of this kid. He's a long, lanky receiver. Get a good fit there at the Tulsa offense next year.
Another penalty flag as Boyd runs, tries to scramble out of trouble, and goes down at the 33-yard line. It'll be a 6-yard gain if it stands. And Kyaris Garrett, 6'5", 185 pounds, coming into the game.
Legal formation, 5 men in the backfield, 5 yard penalty, we play first down.
Coming into the game, Garrett, 56 catches for 1,105 yards and 21 touchdowns, a first-team All-Stater. And that's going to be a common theme we're going to talk about tonight. Both Cameron Yeo and Daingerfield littered with All-State performers this year.
Yeah, it's really a who's who across the All-State rankings and how they played this entire season. You look at there, that guy there, Tyler Boyd, he's second-team All-State quarterback.
High snap, hands it off, Lafayette, and Lamar Lafayette picks up a few, about 5 yards, up to the 27-yard line.
Yeah, I like that name, Lamar Lafayette, LL. And he's a little scat back there, and one of these things that you have to do when you run that spread offense, you've got to have that either a 1-2 punch or that one punch back there to make these defenses play you honest.
Running option, Boyd into trouble. Can't deliver the pitch, and he goes down at the 28-yard line. Only a pickup of one. Tackle was made on the play by a first-team All-Stater, Jairo Campa.
Look at Campa. He's one of these guys that across this front. Now, they play a little bit of an unorthodox type defense. Sometimes they can go to a 3-4 defense That's their base, but they can also go back to a 3-3-5, three down linemen, three linebackers, and also, well, there's a little ball to snap there.
Tyler Boyd wasn't ready for the snap. The ball is loose, and the Yeomen say they have it.
He's down. Yeomen ball.
Edgar Luna recovers it. The nose guard. And the Yeomen have the football in Daingerfield territory. Let's take another look.
Yeah, you see that there. Tyler Boyd is not even paying attention. It hits him. It didn't even get back there to him. It just stepped right about to his feet. And it looked like he's got it chested there, but I think Edgar Luna wrestles it away.
Luna was able to get to the ball and wrestle it away from Boyd before the officials ruled the play dead.
Now they're changing it now.
And now they've changed their mind. I guess one of the officials came in with a different look and convinced Dan Carroll to give the ball back to the Tigers. That's exactly what they do. Yeoman fans not happy about that. But on 4th and 10, they're about to get the ball back anyway. Punt taken at the 38-yard line. And faking the reverse on the return up across midfield down to about the 46-yard line is Jake Young. Actually make that Trevion Sims on the return. And with Sims' return, that sets the Yeoman up in pretty good field position as they trail 7-0.
That's a good job by the Yeoman defense. First of all, they got shell-shocked at first possession of the game, and they rebounded and made a nice defensive stand, forcing that punt there by the Tigers. And now, with a good return, you got your offense inside the Tiger territory.
The Tiger defense giving up just 10.8 points a game. Yo's defense giving up 13. So both these teams with solid defensive units coming into the ball game. Rhodes stands, delivers on the slant, incomplete. Pass was intended for Zach Brashear. Brashear's been one of his leading receivers this year with 804 yards on 35 catches and 12 touchdowns.
He probably should have had 36 here if this ball's a little bit more out in front, but that's a good play there by Kiaris. He's playing a safety spot now, but he comes in and makes a nice spot there. Kiaris Garrett playing that free safety spot.
Second down and 10. And Rhodes will give a handoff to Derek Westbrook. Westbrook with the speed to go to the 25-yard line and pick up the first down. And that's something that the Yeomen like to do. They like to give the ball in running situations to their slot receivers. Westbrook and Zach Brashear both have done a bit of that this year.
Now that's the benefit of having the spread offense. You have more opportunities and you get more of your talented players, your skilled players, that is, opportunities to do plays like this. Now, Derek Westbrook is the leading receiver on this team, but he's also a force running the football.
Rhodes.
Oh boy.
Bad idea against this Daingerfield defense. Tried to deliver it over to Westbrook and get him some open space, and there was no space to be had as Devin Smith closed in like a missile.
Now this guy is second on the team in tackles behind Big Steve Edmond, and he reads this the whole way. And he runs right through the intended receiver, Westbrook. We might not see that play again.
Second down and 16.
See this defense of the Tigers just trying to show blitz. They backed off. They're not coming.
In pursuit now. Downfield, Rhodes delivers incomplete. Pass rush was coming from Donald Bryant, the 6'3", 250-pound senior. Seven sacks on the year and was looking for number 8.
Now that's another All-State guy you're talking about as well. And I think this offensive line may have some trouble against the bigger defensive front, blocking them man-to-man. You can see in this shot right here just how much bigger that defensive line is compared to the offensive line. And that guy there, Donald Bryant, another reason why they're getting pressure back there.
Ball pops off of Rhodes into the hands of Damian Kelly. And Kelly up to the 30-yard line, picks up a yard. And we'll bring up fourth down, another fourth and long situation for the Yeomen.
yard gain to the 34th down.
That's unfortunate. This possession hasn't gone good here for the Yeomen. They started off decent field position, actually great field position. And they very well may be trying to punt here. Not sure yet.
Weren't able to do much with it, and I would think that Rhodes would try to pin Daingerfield deep once again.
Here they go.
Instead, they will go for it. Rhodes throwing to the end zone. Has a man. Did he catch it? Yes. Touchdown. Thomas Wren with his 10th touchdown of the year. A 30-yard throw from Jack Rhodes to Thomas Wren. And the Yeomen are within a point on a big fourth down play.
Now, you give this quarterback time. He hasn't thrown 46 touchdowns in a season for no reason. This guy is accurate with the ball, and that's a great route there by Thomas Wren. He gets underneath the defender, and that's a perfect pass and a great catch there by the Yeomen.
First-team All-District performer Thomas Wren. And for Jack Rhodes, his 47th touchdown pass of the year. The kick is on the way from Rodriguez. It's good. And with 4 minutes left to go in the first quarter, we got a tie ball game at 7 between the Yeomen and the Tigers. Tied up at 7 between Daingerfield and Cameron Yeo. 4 minutes left to go in the first quarter. Doug Anderson with LaDarren McClain at Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield. This fine facility that is managed by the Mansfield ISD has hosted 4 games this weekend. The 1A Division 1 and Division 2 championships and the 2A Division 1, Division 2 championships, and they've done a great job of it.
And they're doing a wonderful job. Just makes you feel like you're at home and always welcome. And it is accommodating to a pretty good crowd here. It is packed on that Yeoman side, and this Daingerfield side is starting to fill up itself too.
Kick will be taken at the 11-yard line, bobbled a bit by Edwin Mims. Mims manages to make his way to the 20 before he's tackled by the Yeoman special teams. Leading the charge there, Lorenzo Anderson.
Well, right now, both of these teams are one for one on explosive plays. We've seen, obviously, the first play of the game, the Tigers going downfield on one big bomb. And then we saw that fourth down and long there by the Yeoman, and they capitalized on a big play. So we're even still, even on the scoreboard. Now, which team is going to settle down here and sustain a drive?
Tyler Boyd in the shotgun. Two receivers to his left, one on the right. He'll hand it off to Lamarce Lafayette, and Lafayette will pick up a couple of yards. Second down and 8 coming up for the Tigers, who average 42 points a game, 374 yards a contest, 204 on the ground, 170 through the air. Playoff victories for Daingerfield over Pottsboro, Grandview, New Boston, and Littlefield. And Littlefield Ball Club, a good team, and they had to survive in that game last week, winning 18-9. Here's Boyd on the run. Across the 35-yard line, holds on to the football and manages the 39. A 17-yard pickup for Tyler Boyd and a first down for Daingerfield.
This is great execution here by the offense. Watch pick number 57, the right tackle, John Smith. You didn't see it there, but he pulls all the way around and gets, and there he is at the top of the screen, makes a good block for his quarterback. And really, when you talk about Tyler Boyd, we said it here earlier, this is just like having another running back in the backfield. This kid is very explosive running with the football.
First down for the Tigers. And Boyd looks downfield, wants to throw. Now he's under pressure. On the rollout, finds his man downfield, Kiaris Garrett, at the 40-yard line for a first down.
That's nice right there. That's called the quarterback keeping the play alive. And you see these defensive defenders. They're trying to corral him. And then he goes out to his security blanket, Kiaris Garrett.
Well, that's just two kids right there that have played a lot of football games together. Two seniors coming together, and a receiver not giving up on his quarterback coming to bail him out.
Tigers, Boyd to run it. Up the middle, breaks a tackle, still on his feet. Inside the 20, 15-yard line. Look at Tyler Boyd go as he breaks tackles all the way for a 27-yard run.
Well, he's a running back, and he's 5'9", 180 pounds. You better wrap him up because he's a little load coming through there. And you see some arm tackling. That's not going to get it. And you see Jesse Westbrook coming in trying to get a piece, and he can't get him down. Now, this is just another running back, but this offensive line right now is starting to lather up a little bit.
For a 2A high school, the offensive line is huge. Boyd throws it complete. It's Edmund. Touchdown. And the big man makes his mark on the offensive side of the ball as Steve Edmund, with a 13-yard touchdown grab, puts the Tigers on top 13-7.
He doesn't get in the game much, but he's effective when he's in there. Good play action pass, get the quarterback rolling out. I don't think too many people want to tackle the big fella out in space.
Linebacker who is committed to the University of Texas now lines up for the extra point. Edmund has had some adversity to overcome in the last couple of years. Lost his father in 2008, lost his uncle last year. This extra point attempt, no good. But the lead for the Tigers is 6, 13-7, with a minute 44 remaining in the first quarter. Let's take another look at his touchdown grab as Tyler Boyd found Steve Edmund for 6.
You see that play action pass right there was enough to hold those linebackers, and that allowed Edmund to get out and outflank the defender. Quarterback put a nice pass out there for the big fella to catch. He's such a just a great talent there. We know he can play some defense, but also showing that he can catch it also.
This Tiger team trying to make some history that's never been done before in Daingerfield, and that is winning 3 state titles back to back to back. Of course, people still talk about the 1983 team in Daingerfield, perhaps the most dominant high school football team that ever set foot on the turf. 632-8, they outscored their opponents that year. 14 shutouts. They allowed only a safety and a touchdown during the season. And on their way to a state championship, they beat Sweeney in the state championship game 42-0. And people still feel like that might be the best high school football team that's ever been. This Daingerfield team, however, trying to make their mark, because the thing about that Daingerfield team in the 80s, they won state titles in 83 and 85, but they lost in the state championship game in 84, so they did not have a chance to three-peat as this team does. On the return, Jake Young actually make that Damian Kelly. Damian Kelly all the way down to the 25-yard line, a 60-yard return, and that's going to give the Yeomen a little fire in their belly as they get a chance to respond to that last touchdown drive.
These Yeomen skilled players are outstanding. I mean, these guys can pick them up and put them down. Look at Damon Kelly. He gets a little crease and he is gone. And it takes a great effort from behind to try to catch him and slow him down. And that's one of the safeties right there, Aaron Lewis. He doesn't make that play. That's a touchdown. Extra starting tailback there for the Yeomen.
Kelly checks into the backfield, probably still a little winded after that 60-yard return. Kelly past the 25, down to the 24-yard line, picked up a yard.
That's awfully tough right there. You just run a kickoff return back and you feel a little winded. And the next play, you've got to take a handoff. That's some Iron Man football right there.
Second down and 9 coming up.
You see the quarterback looking to the sideline, just trying to get the best look, best play on. It's a lot of cover 2 they're seeing right now for the Tigers defense.
Rhodes Rolls out to the right side, looks downfield, now fires it. Caught. Good for a first down. And out of bounds goes Derek Westbrook at about the 10-yard line. It's a 14-yard pickup for the Yeomen.
Well, I'm really impressed. These receivers on both of these programs, these schools, I mean, they're well coached, because when you see your quarterback scrambling, you try to go just show your face and appear so he has somewhere to throw it. A lot of kids don't understand that at this level, but that's a great job by Westbrook to show his face in the picture to his quarterback, and you get a big play off a scramble.
Trying his best to stay in bounds, but couldn't help but step out at about the 10-yard line. Kelly with the handoff, and Kelly bouncing off tacklers. The ball pops loose, and the Tigers have it. Daingerfield recovers the ball inside the 10-yard line. A tremendous defensive play for Daingerfield, and the Tigers avoid a scoring threat from the Yeomen.
That's unfortunate, too, because he has a pretty nice little run right here, and he's going through right there. I couldn't tell. That's Edmund. Edmund gets a hand in there and knocks that ball loose.
And David Mims recovered it for the Tigers. 38 seconds left in the first quarter, and Daingerfield leading by six. Just made a big defensive play.
Well, I just feel like this first quarter has been a track meet. It seemed like we've been running up and down the field, so many big plays.
Boyd rolling out in his own end zone, takes a hit and goes down.
Oh, fumble.
Tried to reach the ball out. It came loose.
Touchdown.
And it's a touchdown for Cameron Yeo. Wow. The Yeomen recover the ball in the end zone. That was Ed May, the senior defensive lineman, who came up with the football. He's getting his helmet slapped over on that Yeoman sideline.
This is the cardinal rule 101. You just don't do that. You throw that ball away. That's clearly a fumble. I think he just lost the ball. I think he was just trying to get out of the end zone and just break the plane, but lost control of the ball.
Ed May, the senior defensive lineman, picked up the ball and rumbled about a half yard into the end zone to tie up the game. And now the Yeomen with a chance to take the lead, but they can't do it.
Are you kidding me?
As the extra point is missed off the foot of Martin Rodriguez, and the ball game is tied at 13 with 31 seconds remaining in the first quarter.
I've seen it all here in this first quarter.
Well,
I'm trying
what,
to catch my breath.
This game's had everything, and we're not even a full quarter into it.
Look at Big Egg May right there catching the fumble, getting to the end zone. Man, what about the mistakes here early? Really by both teams, and that's why we have a 13-13 tie.
A crazy game so far here at Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield. Daingerfield and Cameron Yeo fighting for the 2A Division I state championship and knotted up at 13.
Certainly does not lack for the incitement. People watching online at home.
Well, Cameron Yeo came into this game looking for the first state title since 1981. That year it was a 3A championship. They beat Gilmer 26-3. They've been close a couple of times. 1987, they made the state semifinals, but they haven't been back to the state championship game. And I know a lot of members of that 81 team are here tonight. They made the trip to watch this team try to put their name in the history books. A kick for Martin Rodriguez. Sails inside the 10-yard line. Taken there by Edwin Mims. And Mims up past the 25 to about the 26. 24 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Daingerfield and Cameron Yeo tied at 13.
If you're Tyler Boyd, you've got to shake that last play off there. Get your head about you. Get you right. Go out there and execute the offense. You've done some good things. Obviously, he's been effective running the football. You've got the weapons outside. Shake it off. You've got to gather yourself and get back going again.
Boyd will hand it off on first down up to the 29-yard line, Lamar Lafayette. Second down and seven coming up, and that might be the final play of the first quarter. The clock will run down, and teams will switch sides at the end of 12 minutes. Dangerfield and Cameron Yeo tied at 13 in the 2A Division I state championship game. Back to Mansfield in a moment on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. For the second quarter between Cameron Yeo and Daingerfield. Tied up at 13 between the Tigers and the Yeomen. Doug Anderson, Ladera McLean with you. Happy you're with us on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Tyler Boyd in the shotgun. Fakes a throw. Now a run across the 30. And Boyd to the 35-yard line. Picks up six on that run. About a yard shy of a first down.
That's a pretty neat little play right there. It looked like a busted play, but no, that's a designed quarterback run. He fakes it out here to the left of the screen. Watch pick number 70 pull around as a lead blocker right there. You see that? That's a pretty well-designed play. Well defended, though.
Boyd will run it as good. Blocking up front, manages the 40-yard line, a 5-yard pickup. In that first quarter, Tyler Boyd was 4 of 4 for 129 yards passing, two touchdowns. He also had six carries for 44 yards, so he has been the majority of the Daingerfield offense.
And he's off to a good start here early, and he seems like he's in tune at what the defense is doing and what the Yeomen are showing him. And he's out there making some adjustments, making sure his protection is right, and pretty much a lot of times he's been calling his own number.
Boyd has three receivers on his left side. He looks that way, now looks right. Throws it over the middle. It's caught inside the 30-yard line. Watch out, Darren Terry inside the 15 and down to the 11-yard line. It's a 48-yard gain for Darren Terry. And Terry tonight has two catches, one for 82 yards and one for 48.
Now, the quarterback play here on this play is awesome. He stands, looks left, looks right, pumps right, lets his receiver clear that first level of the defense, and puts a strike on it. I'm impressed right now with these two hooking up. And Darren Terry, that's a threat. And he didn't have many catches of the season coming in tonight's game, but he is definitely leading the way. Very effective against this defense.
Timeout called on the field as Daingerfield calls the timeout with a first and 10 on the Yeoman 11-yard line. Tied up at 13, Daingerfield knocking on the door. We'll see if they can get there when we come back. Cameron Yeo and Daingerfield tied at 13. The Yeomen with the football, or the Tigers with the football on the 11-yard line. First down. Darren Terry has 131 yards receiving on two catches.
Oh, my goodness.
Here's the handoff to Lafayette. Lafayette inside the five and touchdown. Morris Lafayette with his 12th touchdown of the year, and it gives the Tigers the lead back at 19-13.
That's unfortunate, too. The Yeomen had the perfect defense on, guys in position, but couldn't make the play. There's an injured Yeoman down on the turf right there. That's number 20 right there, Jesse Westbrook. But watch from the outside. They're bringing number 9 in, and that's a Cheyenne Black, another linebacker, but he can't get there fast enough, and Westbrook can't make that tackle.
And nobody managed to bring down Lamaris Lafayette. Derek Westbrook had a hit on him, but couldn't knock him down. And Lafayette able to stand his ground into the end zone for the six to make it 19-13. And you would think they might go for two here, but it looks like Steve Edmond is lined up to kick the extra point. This would make it a 7-point game. Edmond, the straight-on toe kicker, punches it through. 20-13 with 10:22 remaining in the first half. Daingerfield has retaken the lead.
it's a pretty impressive drive there. A couple of big plays mixed in there, really by the quarterback, Tyler Boyd. He is certainly keeping the play extended with his feet and finding receivers downfield, and he's been very effective running the ball. And the explosiveness continue here for the Tigers offense.
The Yeoman coming from Central Texas to the northeast of Austin to the southeast of Temple. Daingerfield, of course, in East Texas, due north of Longview. So the two teams meet in Mansfield tonight. And a great crowd on hand to watch this one. The Cameron Yeo side completely full. The Daingerfield home side is almost there. So we're looking at a pretty much capacity crowd here at Vernon Newsom Stadium tonight.
It is awesome to see this. I mean, it's got to be a good feeling out there for the kids.
And you know what else is great about that? I got a report that Cowboy Stadium in Arlington, which is hosting the big 5A game tonight, Trinity and Pearland, that place is approaching almost being full tonight as well. And so when you look at this house being packed, that house being full of fans, it tells you about the state of Texas high school football and what a great game this is and how many people enjoy it around the state.
There's nothing like it. I mean, you can put this state up against any state in America. You're not going to find a better brand of football. And once again, these Yeoman skill players. That Damon Kelly, he can get out in front of people in a hurry. You've got to put a cap on this kid very quick.
Kelly with a nice return up to the 45-yard line. And the Yeoman have started in great field position tonight. This drive, no exception, as Jack Rhodes lines up in the shotgun. Kelly on the handoff. And he has to go out of bounds, a loss of about a yard on the play. He was being chased down by Donald Bryant. You see big Donald Bryant, 6'3", 250 pounds, number 79.
These are just big defensive linemen here for the Tigers and real long-arm defensive end. So it's tough to get out on the corner. And then you've got big Steve Edmond in the middle of it all. This defense has got a little bit of everything thrown at the Yeoman.
Pass over the defense. Incomplete. Haynes was open. And he had it in his hands. He couldn't hold on to it.
That was a perfect pass by the quarterback, Jack Rhodes. Takes a lot of courage to play that quarterback position. He stood in there tall amongst the pressure and delivered a good pass. And that's just taking your eyes off of it.
Third down and 11. Rhodes was the District 12 2A Division 1 MVP this year. Under some pressure, delivers. Ball is knocked down by Donald Bryant.
That's an outstanding play. You can't describe how good a play that is, because they were trying to go outside with the screen. Now Donald Bryant's getting blocked, and he noticed the screen. Well, that's a fine play. You won't see a better play on that right there.
That's outstanding from the senior defensive end. His third pass breakup of the year. Jack Rhodes will punt it away. Back deep to receive it, Aaron Lewis for the Tigers. Rhodes has a near 44-yard average on punts. He'll let this one take a good bounce inside the 20, down at about the 17-yard line. 39-yard punt for Jack Rhodes, and Daingerfield takes over offensively, leading by a touchdown, 20-13. The Yeoman in the playoffs have beaten Newton, Winnie East Chambers, Tatum, and Lago Vista. Head coach Rick Rhodes talking to his son over on that sideline. Rick Rhodes, a former head coach at New Braunfels. He took the Unicorns to a state title game in 2002. They lost to Texas High out of Texarkana that year. He's also coached with Bob Shipley when the two were at Coppell. He was a defensive coordinator there. He was been around the block a time or two, Rick Rhodes. He's been in the big schools, Coppell, Converse, Judson. But when he took the job at Cameron, it was a family decision. His wife and he were looking for a smaller school for their four kids and found the surroundings to be very pleasant in Cameron. And so far, it's been so good.
He certainly has the ingredients to work with. He's got a bunch of kids that believe in what he's preaching and executing their game plans. You don't go 14-0 for nothing.
Boyd trying to buy some time. Looks downfield. Now will run. Picks up the first down and goes out of bounds after a 10-yard gain. He was being chased down by Ty Morgan.
That's that X factor against a defense. You play perfect defense up until a right here. You have nobody really accounting for the quarterback, and you can't really practice and work on this during the week. You can't simulate that type of speed and his elusiveness to get out of the pocket. Pretty well covered downfield by the Yeoman, but man, when a play breaks down, it is a added benefit to offensive coordinators to have a quarterback that can get out and make defenses pay.
Boyd, 66 yards on 9 carries tonight. Hand off to Lafayette, and he goes down shy of the 30-yard line, lost a yard. Tackle on the play made by Cheyenne Black. Black, one of the leading tacklers on this Yeoman ball club, 194 stops on the year.
Cheyenne Black is playing that bandit spot on the defense. When they go to a 3-4, he turns into an outside blitzer. And that's exactly what happened on that play. He got in there, read that play, and he was back there waiting on the ball carry.
High snap. Boyd takes it up the middle. Cuts right side up to the 40-yard line, close to a first down. An 11-yard pickup for Tyler Boyd, and that will move the chains.
They just don't have an answer right now for Tyler Boyd. And these are just straight quarterback runs most of the time here tonight, but he's getting some great blocking up front. The offensive line continued to do a nice job. They caught the defense in somewhat of a dime package. They only had 3 down linemen and 2 linebackers. And 6 defensive backs, and they benefited from it running against that defense.
Play clock down to a second. Snap to Boyd. He hands it off to Lafayette. And Lamar Lafayette to the 40-yard line. No gain.
Tackle by number 54, Jairo Campa.
Under 8 minutes to play in the first half. Daingerfield trying to win their 3rd consecutive state championship in Class 2A. Boyd stands in the pocket, has time to survey the field, now runs. And he is dangerous in the open field. Watch out, past the 50 to the 40-yard line. Tyler Boyd goes 20 yards to pick up a first down for the Tigers.
This kid is just unbelievable. And I thought he missed his receiver down here, Canaris Garrett. Canaris Garrett was wide open at the bottom of the screen, but I don't know if he saw him. But, man, this is a defensive killer. He just breaks his defensive down with his feet.
Boyd approaching a 100-yard rushing game here in the second quarter. Hands off to Lafayette, who will pick up 4. Tyler Boyd, 11 carries for 97 yards in the game. That to go along with a 5-for-5 passing night, LD, and 178 yards and 2 touchdowns.
Hey, you can't start your night off any better than that. I mean, that's being efficient both ways. I mean, throwing the football and running. Can he keep this pace up? That's the only question right now.
Hand off to Lafayette, goes right side, and will dive forward to about the 36-yard line. There is a penalty flag. We'll see what the call is on the field. Dan Carroll, our referee tonight.
Been a pretty clean ball game played to this point. Both of these teams going out there playing hard, playing it the right way.
Holding. It's 10 yards, previous spot, second down.
Holding penalty on the Tigers.
Oh, that's way over
Replay second down. And it will be second down and 17 for Tyler Boyd and the Daingerfield Tigers. Daingerfield picked to finish first in the state in 2A-D1 by Dave Campbell's Texas Football at the beginning of the year. I guess they knew what they were talking about.
Pretty good pick.
They had the Yeoman ranked number 8 in the state in D1. So both teams got a lot of respect at the beginning of the year. Boyd on the slant. Had a receiver open, but Kyaris Garrett could not hold on to it.
That's really uncharacteristic there. Kyaris Garrett is sure-headed as you can possibly get. Perfect pass again by the quarterback. He catches that. He's still off to the races, I believe.
And it's the first incompletion of the night for Tyler Boyd. Look at head coach Barry Bowman over on the Daingerfield sideline. Boyd delivers, has Garrett. This time Garrett holds on to it to the 30-yard line. Good for what should be a first down for the Tigers.
Let me just say this. That's a big-time throw by Boyd. He's on the opposite hash and throws a bullet. I mean a bullet to the far sideline. Kyaris Garrett runs a nice route, gets open, makes that catch this time, and gets that first down. That's a fantastic play there to convert to third and long.
Daingerfield Tigers have won 16 consecutive playoff games. Number 17 would make it a three-peat in Class 2A. Hand off Lafayette inside the 30 to the 26-yard line. Four-yard pickup. You want to talk about hitting the ground running. Their head coach, Barry Bowman, in his third year at the helm and looking for his third state championship, he is 43-3 as the head coach at Daingerfield High School.
I mean, that's incredible.
His overall record 57-19, but I tell you what he's done here at Daingerfield is almost Todd Dodge-like at South Lake Carroll.
Well, he's benefited every year from having some talent. There's another penalty here.
Offense, 5 yards, play the side down.
Of course, he takes over a program that is steeped in tradition. The Tigers, all time, 543 wins, 306 losses. 25 ties. This year marks their 33rd playoff appearance.
That's just impressive to have that longevity year in and year out. This program making some noise in the playoffs.
Second down and 11.
A nice little matchup at the bottom of the screen down here. Got Kyaris Garrett matched up against Travion Sims.
Boyd will run it. He'll go down at the 26-yard line. He picks up 5 yards. That will be shy of a first down. And Boyd will have a third and about 6 coming up.
Yeah, we see a lot of schools when they run this spread offense, they fake that handoff, and then the quarterback will just get in behind the running back a little bit, go off tackle.
296 yards of total offense for Tyler Boyd in the first half here tonight as the Tigers lead it 20-13. Hand off Lafayette. And Lafayette is popped at the 24-yard line. That was a big-time hit by O'Neal Spells, the district defensive MVP, a second-team All-State performer this year.
He is the leading tackler on this team, and he plays the middle linebacker spot perfect. I mean, that is a form tackle filling the hole. It looked like it was going to be a big play. You had big old Chevion Hutton out there blocking.
This is a big play. 4th and 4. Tigers going for it. Boyd fakes the handoff. Now flips it. Has a man caught for the first down. Steve Edmond coming through again in the clutch. The big man picks up the first down.
That's the same play they scored a touchdown on in the first quarter. Play action pass, roll the quarterback out, a naked bootleg. Hey, get it out to the big fella once again. Tough matchup for anybody to cover this guy.
You hear so much about him as a linebacker, you don't really take into account sometimes that this guy's got a pretty good set of hands. He's a good tight end as well. Hand off Lafayette inside the 10-yard line. 5-yard pickup for Lamar's Lafayette. And the Tigers are knocking on the door with 2:35 remaining in the first half.
Now, this offensive line, we talked about it, is pretty physical. Right now, they are getting some good push and good movement up front. And now you're starting to see these little ones and two little yard runs turned into 3 to 4, maybe 5, 6 yards runs now.
Trips to the left side. Boyd goes right on the fade. Up in the air, incomplete. Looking for Darren Terry.
Good matchup in the outside there. Number 25, Trey Anderson, is 5'7", 130, but he's an athlete. He's in pretty good position. That's actually a pretty good throw. I thought Darren Terry might be able to go up and snap that one down with both hands.
Third and 5 from the 9-yard line. And Boyd will throw the high fade for Garrett this time. Jump ball. Garrett, can he hold on to it? Yes. Touchdown. Kiaris Garrett with hands like glue that time to hold on to the ball and take a hit. Good for 6 points. He got popped by Derek Westbrook, but still managed to hold on to the ball.
Yes, he did. And that ball could have hung up so long, it could have brought rain with it. I mean, look how long this pass is up in the air. I mean, he throws an absolute rainbow. And yes, Kiaris Garrett did pay the price for it, but he holds on and benefits from just out jumping like a rebound and scoring that touchdown.
Well, those are the benefits of having a 6'5 wide receiver. And the toe punch from Edmund, good for the extra point. 27-13, our score. Daingerfield leading Cameron Yeo with 2:11 remaining in the first half. Daingerfield up 27-13 with 2:11 remaining in the first half. 16 plays, 82 yards on that last drive. 7 minutes and 36 seconds come off the clock for Daingerfield. A good use of the play clock and the game clock on that last drive as Daingerfield was able to convert a couple of key third downs, even a fourth down, keep that drive going and find themselves in the end zone. Kiaris Garrett with the touchdown grab. Edmund kicks this one to the 10-yard line. And they try the reverse, but the ball is loose on the turf, and it's picked up by the Tigers. The recovery by Devin Smith. Every time that they've had a return, the Yeomen have shown a reverse look. Now, they've never actually tried to run the reverse. The first ball carrier has always kept the ball. This time they try to hand it off, and it doesn't work.
Yeah, you didn't get as good shine of it there, but I think that's just unnecessary. You didn't need to try to hand it off this time. You've had some success just faking it. Just so much to worry about when you've got too much ball handling in the return game. And that could really spell some doom here early for the Yeomen.
Well, that means that the Tigers have a chance to blow this thing open just a little bit with 2 minutes left in the first half. Boyd, keeper inside the 10 to the 9-yard line, picks up 3. Second down and 7 coming up. Well, you just don't want to give Tyler Boyd the ball back as hot as he's been in this first half.
No, he's on fire and clicking on all cylinders. I mean, the passing game, he makes the passes where he wants to. He's been able to run when he wants to. Well, the last thing this Yeoman wants is a hot quarterback in scoring position in the red zone.
Lafayette picks up a yard. Less than 90 seconds remaining in the first half.
Pretty sure it might be a chance down here. You still have that matchup. Here's Garrett matched up against Travion Sims in distinctive height advantage. Garrett 6'5", Sims 5'9".
Garrett's the tallest guy on the field and certainly one of the most athletic as well. Daingerfield letting the play clock run down before calling a timeout. 56 seconds remaining in the first half. Tigers with one timeout remaining. trying to set up their offense for a last-minute score here in the first half. And, boy, if they find the end zone here, what a big, big hole that puts Cameron Ewing going into the halftime locker room.
And it pretty much will make then the second half one-dimensional, because now you play right back into the hands of this Daingerfield Tiger defense. And their success on defense is getting pressure to the quarterback and playing good coverage behind it. So this is a big stop here for the Yeomen. They need to at least hold this team to 3 points, or at least attempt a three-pointer. Because you cannot go down 34-13 or any more than that.
Third down and six for the Tigers. Daingerfield has moved the ball at will in this first half. 213 passing yards for Tyler Boyd, 105 rushing.
And they're backing off these receivers, giving them space.
Boyd tried to dump it off, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jared Buckhausen.
How about that play?
Well, that's something that the Yeomen needed, certainly. Boyd tried to flip it over the hands of Beckhusen, and he just came up with the football.
I mean, he snags this completely out of it, actually tipped it to himself.
Did his own version of a tip drill.
Oh, man, that you talk about timely defensive plays. You can't get any bigger than that.
I mean, that one is a huge play for Cameron Yeo, because not only does it give him the ball, but it keeps the Tigers from extending their lead here at the end of the first half. Now Rhodes will go deep, and he almost gets picked off. Pass falls to the turf. Aaron Lewis is going to argue he had an interception, but he did not.
I think actually on that play, Rhodes gets popped, and he couldn't get enough oomph on this pass. Watch the protection at the end break down just a little bit, and you got a little bit of pressure at his face, and he just couldn't step into that throw. Zach Bashir, number 23, got a step on the defender.
And a penalty goes against Daingerfield. So Yeoman will have the ball on the 34-yard line. A 15-yard penalty. That had to be a personal foul penalty against the Tigers.
Might be an enhance to the face of the quarterback. We didn't see the end of that play, but it surely looked like a late hit or roughing the passer perhaps.
Five penalties for Daingerfield for 40 yards in this game. Rhodes stays alive, throws to the sideline, caught at the 45-yard line by Derek Westbrook, and he gets out of bounds with 34 seconds remaining in the half. 12-yard pickup for Westbrook, who this year has been an all-district performer and honorable mention all-state. 1,000 yards on the season, 16 touchdowns.
And he does a fine job coming back to his quarterback once again.
Rhodes back to Westbrook on the slant. And Westbrook will take it to the 45-yard line. The Yeomen have three timeouts remaining. That's a 9-yard pickup.
They need to burn one here.
And they will. Cameron Yeo calls their first timeout. They've got two left with 24 seconds left on the clock. And they've got plenty of time to get at least into field goal position.
Yeah, I think so. And if they can get maybe 10, maybe 15 yards here within the next few seconds and not taking too much more off the clock, yeah, you can get into some field goal range here. Then you can start maybe thinking about taking a couple of shots in the end zone if you've got secured field position. You've got two timeouts, so certainly no time to panic. You made some good plays. You could even maybe call the play across the middle of the defense. Call the timeout immediately.
Daingerfield fans having a good time at Vernon Newsom Stadium. Rick Rhodes up on the Cameron Yeo's sideline, 20-4 in his 2 years with the Yeomen.
Now, right now, the Tigers are showing a cover two man underneath coverage look.
Rhodes delivers downfield, throws it into double coverage, and it's caught. A great catch at the 19-yard line and down at the 17. Zach Brashear with a first down, and I don't know how he caught that ball. I thought for sure it was going to be picked off.
Well, he went up and out-muscled Kiaris Garrett. He went up and took it out the sky. Now, they can save a timeout and spike it here, but they're going.
Trying to catch the Tigers off guard. They flip it to Kelly. That one's incomplete, and that works to stop the clock with 8 seconds left in the first half.
I think that took too much time off the clock. I think that was a wasted play. I think they could have either called the timeout and saved them more time and get a better play, and there you go. See Bashir going up and just snagging that football. I think that surprised Aaron Lewis, too.
The Yeomen have two timeouts left.
I think you're in field goal position right now.
I think you're in range. They might want to take one more shot at the end zone with a timeout to burn. Penalty flag thrown. There was movement. And a quick flip underneath to Kelly. Kelly with a zigzag move into the end zone. Touchdown.
Wow.
There are two penalty flags on the play. We'll have to sort these out before we get an official indication of the score. But, boy, if that is a touchdown, that is a great play by Jack Rhodes and Damian Kelly.
Damian Kelly makes a beautiful cut to get himself free in the end zone. I thought this was a defensive offsides to me. I thought this was encroachment.
I think the two penalties will be offsetting. You'll have encroachment on Daingerfield, but a holding penalty on Cameron Yeo.
Yeah, you see the laundry in the backfield like that. 9 out of 10 times, that's what that call is going to be.
Offside.
You see a little bit of encroachment there.
The receiver downfield, offense, goes offset, one on time down.
So since the half cannot end on a penalty,
Daingerfield. That's all
the Yeomen will have one untimed down to play with no time on the clock.
I think it's a no-brainer. You kick it down, right?
Absolutely. You take the 3 points. They made a nice play to get into the end zone, but the offsetting penalties negate that. So now the Tigers have basically a free play at the end of the first half here. And I think absolutely if you're the Yeoman, you try to kick it. That would make it a 27-16 ball game. You'd be down by 11.
And it gives you a chance to regroup going into halftime, eh? Benefited from a great defensive play. Really a lucky play, but a great play nonetheless. Go ahead, take your 3 points while you got a chance. You don't want to try to take a shot in the end zone here. It might not get it, but, man, they seem to be rolling the offense out here.
Well, you and I can talk about it all we want up here in the broadcast booth. What they do on the field is a different thing entirely, and it looks like they are going to go for it here on the final play of the first half. I mean, if you're Daingerfield, you just put everybody in the end zone, I would think.
I don't get this one.
Rhodes goes down, taken down by that Daingerfield defense. And that was Devin Smith, the first man to him, and that will end the first half. Yeah, that was a wasted play by the Yeoman. And as we go to halftime, the Daingerfield Tigers, the two-time defending state champions in Class 2A, looking for a three-peat and leading 27-13. Back to Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield in a moment on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Getting ready to start the second half. Daingerfield leading Cameron Yeo 27-13 in the Class 2A Division I State Championship. Doug Anderson with LaDarren McLean. And let's take a look at those first half highlights. Started off very well for Daingerfield as on the first play of the game, Tyler Boyd finds Darren Terry for an 82-yard touchdown bomb. Jack Rhodes responded in kind with a touchdown pass for Cameron Yeo to put them on the board and tie the game at 7. But then Steve Edmond got into the act, making a touchdown grab. And it was Kiaris Garrett reeling one in as well from Tyler Boyd. Mars Lafayette with a touchdown run for the Tigers. And at the end of the first half, Daingerfield with a 27-13 lead. We take a look at the numbers, LD. And Tyler Boyd was a one-man gang in that first half, running for 105 yards, passing for 213 and three touchdowns, as he really was the spark plug for the Tigers offense.
And he's accounted for over 300 of total yards himself out of the 355 total yards of offense in that first half. So, and this kid is pretty much doing it all. And he's got his team right positioned well here for the 14-point lead.
For Cameron Yeo, they were led by Jack Rhodes in that first half passing-wise, 9 of 15 for 98 yards and a touchdown. Rushing-wise, it was Damian Kelly who had 6 carries for 15 yards in that first half. So if you were to point to something for the Yeomen in the second half, I would think that one of the things you'd want to do if you were Rick Rhodes is do something to get the running game going a little bit. That will do a couple of things for you. Number one, that will keep the Daingerfield offense off the field if you can play a little more ball control. And the other thing that will do is that will give your team a chance to gain some confidence. If you know you can move the ball, if you can run the ball against this Daingerfield Tiger defense, then yeah, I think that gives you a confidence boost that you need.
I certainly agree with you on that. You need to keep this Daingerfield offense off the field. And the Yeomen have been pretty good. They've had 38 takeaways now with the takeaway just to close that first half out this year. So they've done a good job of that, but I agree with you. They get back to running the football, slow this game down. You don't want to get in a track meet with the Daingerfield Tigers. I think you may have a chance to still be two-dimensional and not one-dimensional in this second half.
Tigers on the field and the Yeomen run through their tunnel and they are on the field as well as we get ready for the second half here at Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield. This is the final game of a Saturday triple-header of state championship action. Earlier in the day, the Mark Panthers won the state championship in Class 1A Division 1 with a 28-7 victory as they were able to beat the Goldthwaite Eagles. And then earlier this evening in Class 2A Division 2, the Idaloo Wildcats played excellent defense on their way to a 20-3 win over the Lexington Eagles for Idaloo's first ever state championship. I was talking with some guys at the halftime intermission, and the consensus was as good as Idaloo is, and they played a very good ball game today, and their defense is outstanding. But you can really tell the difference between 2A Division 2 and 2A Division 1 in the terms of athletes and the kind of speed that's on the field.
I certainly agree, and it's no secret to that. It just raises up a notch, just a little bit more. The speed of the game certainly changes when you get to this level here. It's been some fireworks here in this game in the first half, and I'm pretty sure we're going to be treated to some more fireworks here in this second half.
Daingerfield will kick it away. Daingerfield is located in Morris County, the county seat. Taking on the Cameron Yeoman. Cameron, the county seat of Milan County. And a lot of fans from both counties are here tonight.
Well, they are here and representing well. And been treated to a pretty good game. It's a 14-point lead right now, but like I said before, plenty of fireworks. The Yeomen are still in striking distance.
Steve Edmond kicks it deep. They will run the reverse to Damon Kelly. And Kelly goes down 15-yard line. And that's where the Yeomen will start offensively here in the second half. Jack Rhodes will lead the Yeoman offense. He was 9 of 15 in that first half for 98 yards and a touchdown. His leading receiver was Derek Westbrook, who had 4 catches for 28 yards.
And I think a lot of those plays were where the quarterback just extended the play with his feet, scrambled around, and found Westbrook in the secondary.
Hand off to Kelly, and he's hit in the backfield, dropped for a 2-yard loss. And it didn't take long for Devin Smith to find Damon Kelly.
No, it didn't. Yeah, he snuffed that play out pretty quickly. It surprises me that the Yeomen would come out real conservative there. I thought they would probably start trying to throw more on first down.
Seems like every play in that first half when they had a first and whatever, they were running the football. So it surprised me they come out trying to run straight ahead again.
Take the handoff to Kelly, give it to Westbrook. And Westbrook makes his way up to the 14-yard line. Only picks up a yard back from that 2-yard loss. D.D. Westbrook, first team all-district performer. 16 touchdowns on the year. Third down and 11 for the Yeomen. Rhodes has time to throw, gets rid of it, and it is picked off by Kiaris Garrett. Garrett in the middle of the field had that one read all the way. Rhodes, not a very good throw, and Garrett comes up with the interception. That's his 7th INT of the year.
Now, when you're playing the quarterback position, you've got to have that thought process in your mind. I don't want to try to force nothing late down the middle of the field. It's okay to punt. We're only down 14 points, and now you create things worse for your team. Now, you put them in an awful spot on defense, and this red-hot offense has been unstoppable all evening.
The Yeomen with 3 turnovers in this ball game. Daingerfield with a 2. Hand off to Lamarce Lafayette, and Lafayette reaches the 31-yard line, about a 6-yard pickup. Second down and 4 coming up.
6-yard gain. And that's a pretty good chunk of yards there on first down. And that's the one thing that I thought they didn't really get too much established. That's a great play by Boyd.
Boyd had to just handle the high snap, throws it to the end zone and out of bounds. Garris Garrett was the intended receiver. Boyd on the turf. Back at the 42-yard line, see Garrett coming back. He tripped over that pylon. He might have lost his balance, and he's limping a little bit as he comes back to the huddle.
A little gimpy, but he's lining up in his wide receiver spot, ready to go. You see the game plan there. That play was 4 receivers just going deep on that play, and the Daingerfield Tigers are saying, hey, let's continue on the attack here.
Another high snap, handoff to Lafayette. And Lamarce Lafayette nailed at the 31-yard line. No gain as the tackle was made by Ty Morgan. Morgan, a first-team all-district performer, one of the leading tacklers on this Yeomen ball club.
Well, he does an excellent job of just slipping the blockers and just getting back. There is a great shot here. Look how he gets in there, reads that play. When you see those guards pulling, and he's keying off right tackle John Smith. When he sees that, he's going to get right behind his hip, and lo and behold, the ball carry was right there.
On 4th and 4, Boyd rolls out, throws it into double coverage, incomplete. Steve Edmond was asking for an interference penalty, but it's not coming.
It's over, Smack! Come on!
And the ball goes over on downs to the Yeomen. We'll take another look at it here.
You can probably call that, but that's a pretty good no call. Right?
I think that's an instance where the referee is smart just to let him play.
I agree.
First down for the Yeomen. 3 receivers on the right side. Hand off to Damon Kelly. He avoids one man in the backfield. Picks up yardage to the 40 and goes out of bounds there. A 9-yard pickup for Damon Kelly, close to a Yeomen first down.
Now they're really trying to force this run on first down. I didn't think they'd have any kind of success doing it, but they get the defense in a position where they can go outside. That's a dangerous block right there by number 17, Westbrook. Now this kid here can move. He's a little bitty guy. You said it, Doug. He's only 5'5", 160 pounds. But he can scat.
He got enough for the first down, so it's 1st and 10 for the Yeomen as Rhodes will run it across the 45 up to near the 47-yard line. 6-yard pickup for Jack Rhodes.
Little option look here. Rhodes sees the first little sign of daylight, and he cuts up in there pretty quickly. But if you think you can have success on first down running the ball, why not continue to do it? You can handle these second and fours. This offense is pretty explosive. First time tonight they've emptied the backfield.
And Rhodes looking for a completion. The ball was knocked down. I think that was Donald Bryant who got his paw up there and was able to slap the ball down. That's the fourth time this year he's knocked down a pass, the second time tonight.
And big Donald Bryant, and when he sees that defense, or excuse me, that offensive tackle trying to cut him, he knows automatically it's a quick pass and he can't get there, so automatically turn yourself back into an athlete, knock that pass down.
Third down and four. Tripp set up to the left side for Jack Rhodes.
Press coverage on the outside by the Tigers D.
Pump fake and a throw over the middle. Derek Westbrook catches it at the 50 and falls to the 49-yard line. Good for a first down for the Yeomen.
Nice job there by Westbrook to turn himself into a basketball player, shield that defender off. They had all slants going on, man coverage, and you've got to get inside that defender. Westbrook did it there.
Yeomen trying to respond to a 14-point deficit at halftime. See if they can cut into that lead. Damon Kelly with a nice run through the middle, trying to cut back to the left side. Picked up the first down with a 13-yard run.
Now you're starting to see this offensive line not only make blocks or get to their blocks, but maintain them. Big number 77 there, Josh Smitherman. He does a nice job of holding that block so Kelly can get in behind it. And Kelly's a shifty guy. He can see the entire field. Garrett had to go get him.
Rhodes on first down. Pass to Westbrook is caught, but only a yard or two picked up on the play. Devin Smith made the stop, and boy, Devin Smith has been all over the field tonight. And he's especially been keeping an eye on Derek Westbrook.
And he's one of these hybrid linebackers, and he plays around the line of scrimmage, but he can also go back there with Steve Edmond. It's a pretty good tandem of linebackers there for the Titans.
5.5 tackles tonight for Devin Smith, 3 of them for loss. Damon Kelly with the run to the 35-yard line. A penalty flag was thrown on the play.
We have a chop block on the offense. That's a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. They played today.
Yeah, I thought they could actually call that an earlier ago. But we'll probably get a good shot here. That's a good call right there, right on number 74. Jesse Hansen, he's the defensive tackle. And when an offensive lineman is already engaged up high, you can't have another lineman come in and cut his legs out. That's an illegal block.
And a penalty against the Yeomen. 15 yards. Second down and 24 now. Pass complete, 40-yard line to the 35 and down to the 30-yard line for Zach Brashear, a 21-yard gain.
Number 11, Aaron Lewis.
That turns second and 24 into third and three.
It's a nice, well-designed play. This is what they have to do. They have to get back, let these receivers cut the secondary up a little bit in that zone look, and have the quarterback make quick decisions and get the football out. I think if they can get it to these skill players, these guys have some ability to do something.
Rhodes throws the bubble screen, and that is ineffective. The pass was complete to Travian Sims, but Sims gets hit in the backfield by Reuben Mims. One of the Mims boys makes a nice tackle on this play.
Well, Thomas Wren, number four, the outside receiver right there on your screen. He's got to hold that block a little bit better than that, or you're going to have your running back or your receiver may get into a blow-up like this.
I think the one thing that we've learned in this ballgame for sure about the Daingerfield defense, though, is that you can't go laterally against this defense. You're not going to go sideline to sideline. You have to go up and down the field. You cannot. You've got to play a vertical game. Rhodes tries to throw it on fourth and nine, and the ball is knocked down, and so is the receiver by Kiaris Garrett. as he came in behind the receiver on the play, Jared Beckhusen, and just put him on the turf.
I just don't get the need for a fake punt. I mean, you're giving momentum back to the Daingerfield Tiger side as if they didn't need any more momentum. That's a great play by Kiaris Garrett.
And a big stand on fourth down for the Tigers as they lead 27-13 with 5:26 remaining in the third quarter.
Now, football is all a game of emotion and momentum. And I just think they've made some poor decisions. Obviously, the one going into the halftime locker room, not getting the 3 points. No need for a fake punt here either.
Morris Lafayette picks up about 8 yards, maybe nine on that run to the 45-yard line. Second down and one coming up for the Tigers.
9 yard gain to the 45-yard line, second down and one.
Well, Morris Lafayette lathering up pretty good here. We talked about he's an all-state running back also, honorable mention. He's had some nice success on first down runs and really dangerous now for the Yale defense. You've got second and one. It's tough to defend these guys.
Hand off to Lafayette. Won't pick up the first down. In fact, he'll be pushed back. Officially spotted at the 44-yard line, a loss of a yard. Tigers and the Yeomen were tied up at 13 at the end of the first quarter. And then 14 second quarter points for the Tigers gave them the advantage they hold now, 27-13.
Now they benefited from some miscues of the Yeoman offense.
Tyler Boyd up the middle will not get the first down as he was stuffed by that Yeoman defense. And that was Edgar Luna on the front line who made the tackle, the district defensive newcomer of the year in 12-2A Division I.
And you also see Holt right there, number 58, coming in from the side as well helping out. I think that's some poor play calling there on the Tigers. I mean, you had a second and one. You mean to tell me you can't throw the football and back these guys off? They're looking for you to run. I just think that's a bad taking advantage of the situation in it.
And on fourth down, Tigers will punt the ball away, taken at the 26-yard line. And up to the 31 on the return. And that's where the Yeomen will start. When we come back to Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, Tigers leading by 14. Yeoman take over on first down from the 32-yard line. Rhodes complete up to the 40. And his man still fighting for yardage. Play finally whistled dead. That completion went to Thomas Wren. And Wren was able to come close to a Yeoman first down. In fact, he'll pick it up.
Yeah, you see what happens when you throw the ball on first down. You've had some success running a little bit on first down. Now you've got the defense kind of trying to play your tendencies. And when you raise up and throw it, you're going to have soft coverage. And there you go. You benefit and pick up a first down.
Westbrook lined up on the wing. He'll take the handoff. And Westbrook lets the ball pop loose. It's in the air. The Daingerfield Tigers have it at midfield.
Oh, wow. How about that play?
The recovery was by Dejon Mims at midfield. And it was Steve Edmond, the all-world linebacker, who stripped the ball.
Well, you want to talk about textbook, not only making the tackle, but textbook stripping a ball carrier. Watch this. Can't do it any better than that.
Oh, that's beautiful. Edmond put it right up in the air, and Dejon Mims came after it after that for the recovery, and Daingerfield has the ball at midfield, leading 27-13.
Now, it's been uncharacteristic for the Yeoman today. They've been in the plus in the turnover margin all season long. Right now, they find themselves losing that turnover battle here tonight.
Kiaris Garrett with the reception, but no gain as he stopped at the line of scrimmage. Tackled by Jarrett Beckhusen.
Number 11, Jarrett Beckhusen with the tackle. No gain.
This offense can't get too conservative. You're only up 14 points, and the Yeoman have shown signs of being able to move the ball. So you've got to continue to do what you've done in the first half. Attack this defense. You cannot get complacent.
and let this team hang around.
Second and 11. Boyd's throw to Garrett, complete at the 40 and down to the 39-yard line where he's close to a first down. An 11-yard pickup for Kiaris Garrett.
Such an accurate passer that Tyler Boyd is. And you got a big 6'5 receiver. It's pretty easy to spot him in amongst some shorter defenders in that secondary. Well, a lot of people changing out here on this play here. You got guys coming off the bench, linemen switching out. Steve Edmond out there.
It's third and one. Edmond lines up as a tight end. And you've got a Tiger checking himself out of the game. That's Darren Terry. Looks like something might be wrong with his helmet, or either that he just wasn't involved in the play.
Yeah, I think that's right. I think you're the latter, Doug. I think they've gone to a heavy look. You got a lot of big bodies on that line of scrimmage and one wide receiver. And you've got a big boy in the backfield dubbing as a fullback, and I think that's Jesse Hansen.
Jesse Hansen, the nose tackle, and he will block for Tyler Boyd, who goes right over the top to pick up the first down. Tyler Boyd playing like a man possessed tonight.
He is. And they run right behind big Jesse Hansen. Watch Jesse make a good block. I mean, he just annihilates that. This is a great shot here, too. Oh, poor Ty Morgan. He's getting a lot thrown at him automatically.
First and 10 for the Tigers. And Boyd, a nice run to the 30-yard line, 6-yard gain.
Offense starting to get back to that flow once again. They're starting to get into a rhythm. And now I tell you, when an offense struggles, if you can lean on your running game and pick up some first downs. You don't always have to make plays. But if you can make first downs, it gives some confidence back to this offensive line and back to your skilled players. You're starting to see that here now.
Lamaris Lafayette finds a hole, picks up the first down to the 21-yard line, a 9-yard gain for Lafayette. And the Tigers, trying to add to their 14-point lead, have a fresh set of downs.
Now they're starting to pick it up. And Lafayette finding some creases in this defense. And it's going to be a point in time here. Maybe they're getting close into the red zone. Play-action pass would really kill this secondary. They're starting to cheat up a little bit. They're starting to feel that running game lean on them a little bit. Now they're emptying the backfield now.
And Boyd, under some pressure, throws incomplete. Second and 10 coming up.
Yeah, he missed him on that one, and that's one of the defenders coming in, dubbing as a wide receiver. That's Aaron Lewis, one of the captains on this team, running wide open in the middle of the field. Boyd couldn't get it to him.
Fifteen seconds left in the third quarter, and Boyd will hand off to Lafayette. Lafayette hit and dropped at the 21-yard line. Might have gained a yard on that run.
Ty Morgan with the stop.
And that will be the final play of the third. So 12 more minutes left in the high school football season of 2010. And the Daingerfield Tigers are trying to wrap up the year with their third consecutive state championship. We'll see if they can do it when we come back on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Ahead of the fourth quarter from Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, Doug Anderson with Ladera McClain. 27-13, our score. Daingerfield leading Cameron Yeo in the 2A Division I state championship match.
All right, well, Steve Edmonds in the game, and when he's been in the game on third down, he has been the primary target.
And Boyd looks his way, now throws into the fray inside the 10-yard line for Kiaris Garrett. Incomplete. Garrett was double covered. And would have been a miraculous catch had he been able to come up with it.
Now, pretty good play outside number two, Trayvon Sims. And he gets some help from Westbrook playing the free safety this time. That's a perfect hat on ball and dislodging it from Kiaris Garrett.
Fourth down and eight. The Tigers don't have much of a kicking game, so they go for it. Boyd looks downfield, throws one to the sideline. Garrett in and out of his hands. It was right off the fingertips. It would have been good for a first down had Garrett been able to catch it. But instead, the Yeomen get the ball back, and they stay alive in this ballgame with 11:49 left.
Well, Garrett's got to make this catch. It's a pretty good pass under pressure. Throws it to the outside. You got to make that catch. You're going to need to make it in Tulsa. It's tough, but you get your hands on it, you're supposed to snag it.
This Daingerfield ball club has been a part of so much history. Their current team trying to make it right now with a three-peat in Class 2A. But going back to that 83 team that we talked about earlier, also you fast forward 20 years to 2003, they were a part of history back then as Jack Rhodes throws one incomplete over the middle, second down and 10 coming up. 2003, in the playoffs, the Tigers met the Salina Bobcats, the team that had won four consecutive state championships and was riding a 68-game winning streak. And Daingerfield is the team that ended that streak in Garland at Williams Stadium. I had a chance to actually do that game on the Texas State Network, and it was a pandemonium-like scene there when Salina finally went down. Daingerfield celebrating the end of a long winning streak for Salina, the state record 68 games in a row.
Yeah, many people thought that team would never lose, and history made.
Jack Rhodes picks up the first down up to the 35-yard line. 13-yard run for Rhodes.
Well, I tell you what, Doug, you let this team hang around, and they are still playing hard, still believing. You can come down here on this possession and come away with some points. You got yourself a different ballgame, and I think the pressure will shift back towards the Daingerfield Tigers. But this Yeomen offense has got to make plays. They've got to go now.
Rhodes facing the pressure, dumps it off to Kelly. Kelly will pick up the first down. Edmonds will chase him out of bounds. And a penalty flag, late hit, will be the call against Steve Edmonds. And Edmond is hurt over on the Cameron Yeo sideline. That's limping as he comes back onto the field.
Now, I think that play had an awkward end to it in front of the...
Late hit out of 15 yards from the spot. First down.
15-yard penalty against the Tigers on the late hit by Steve Edmond.
Now, if there's any doubt that Steve Edmond cannot move... Now, keep in mind, Damian Kelly is a burner. And look at this play. That's a penalty. That's pretty impressive, showing him his speed, getting to the outside. And Yeoman making some plays, getting penalties, and they're keeping the chains moving.
Six penalties for the Tigers, 55 yards. And penalties for Cameron Yeo. That's what they've taken advantage of tonight.
Edmonds got to come off the field.
Steve Edmonds will have to come off the field at least for a play. And in his place, Cordarius Anderson, freshman, comes onto the field.
Talking about experience drop-off.
Well, not only that, you talk about a size drop-off as well. You're talking about a 6'3", 235-pound linebacker being replaced by a guy who's about 5'5", and 150. Rhodes runs the option. Kelly. And Kelly knocked out of bounds around the 31-yard line. Might have been a 5-yard pickup for Damian Kelly. And Cameron Yeo not going away just yet.
That's what I'm saying. And this defense has kept them in the ballgame. And really the conservative play of the Daingerfield Tigers, they have not been able to capitalize once they get into the red zone. Let the team hang around.
Rhodes has some time to throw, goes over the middle, has a receiver, it's caught. Quinn Haynes, he took a pop, but he held onto the football, good for a first down and a 17-yard pickup.
Oh, that is outstanding. That's what you play football, that's what it's all about. You know you're going to get popped, why not hold on to the football?
was Aaron Lewis that made the hit trying to separate Haynes from the football, but he couldn't do it.
Oh, man, that's bringing a shot there. That's a clean hit, too. That's a big play there for the Yeomen.
Ball lined up on the right hash. Three receivers on the left side for Jack Rhodes. Rhodes loses the football temporarily. It's loose at the 10-yard line. And the first indication says Daingerfield football, but the official sees a Yeoman come up off the turf with it. That was the center, Jacob Kostrown.
Watch big number one. Guess who?
Yeah, Steve Edmonds stripping the ball once again.
Once again, he knows how to get his hand on the football, even when he's out of position. He still makes a play that dislodges that football.
Well, he was bringing the blitz, and Jack Rhodes knew that the Tiger defense was going to overcommit. That's why he decided on the play up the middle, but Edmund was still able to reach out there and grab that ball, but he can't stop Damian Kelly this time as Kelly goes in from 10 yards out for a Yeoman touchdown.
Yeah, game on. Game on now. You've had your chances to put this team away early. You had a chance to put them away in the first half. Pretty crafty play, direct snap to Kelly, fools everybody. They think the quarterback has the ball. He goes in the end zone pretty much untouched. Game on.
Absolutely. The Yeoman have a chance to make it a 7-point game with the extra point. Martin Rodriguez. Kick is on the way, and it is good. Our score with 9:47 left in the game. Daingerfield 27, Cameron Yeo 20. We've got a ball game at Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield. Daingerfield with a 7-point lead, 9:47 remaining in the game, about to get the ball back. But they have just seen the Yeoman march downfield on a 7-play drive that went 79 yards and took 2 minutes and 2 seconds off the clock. Finished off by a Damon Kelly 4-yard, 10-yard touchdown run. For Kelly, his 24th rushing touchdown of the year.
It's been a long time since this offense of the Daingerfield Tigers has put some points on the board. It was about midway through that second quarter that they scored the 27th point. Haven't done anything since. They've had some opportunities. They've benefited from some turnovers, but haven't capitalized on it.
The return from David Mims. Penalty flag thrown on the field. Mims will go down around the 29-yard line. Couple of penalty flags on the play. And I think something you mentioned earlier is bears repeating, LD, and that is that when a team goes into the lead, it goes into halftime with a significant lead like Daingerfield did, 14 points, for some reason there's a tendency.
The receiving team, 10 yards from the flag, first down.
There's a tendency to come out in the second half and play conservative, try to hold on to that lead, try to nurse it home, and that's not Daingerfield's style.
No, it's not, and you get a good shot of the block in the back there. There was another one after as well that wasn't in that shot. But, yes, I agree, Doug. And really what really showed that, and a second and one at midfield, and they ran two consecutive run plays in the middle of that defense. That, to me, is conservative play calling. You need to let this kid fling it. Second and one, you've got receivers. They've shown they can get behind the Yeoman defense. Tee it high and let it fly. That's your game.
And certainly Tyler Boyd not lacking in any confidence whatsoever to know that he could throw the ball downfield.
You play that quarterback, you got to have a little moxie about you, a little cockiness. Not too much cockiness, but a little swagger. A little swagger. Yeah, he's out there trying to direct traffic a little.
Got a problem with Kyaris Garrett now, as Garrett is going to have to go to the sideline. Apparently there's some blood on his uniform, pointing to his knee. And the trainer will take a look at that. Meanwhile, Boyd will keep it. And forward he goes to the 15-yard line. Picks up only a yard. Second down and 9 coming up.
Yeah, the momentum certainly has swung back to the Yeomen. And now they're trying to fly around on defense. You see O'Neill Spells there. Second team all-state linebacker. Filling that gap pretty nicely.
Spells 227 tackles credited this year. Not exactly sure how Coach Rhodes and his staff keep defensive stats, though, because I'll tell you about that in a minute. Boyd trying to make something happen as he improvises up to the 20-yard line, 5-yard gain. You look at the defensive numbers that were supplied this week for the Yeomen, and you've got a guy with 227 tackles, another one with 225, another one with 194, another one with 160, another with 184, another with 170. There can't be that many tackles in the entire year.
I don't think it's that many. Not too many plays.
I guess maybe it's one of those deals, kind of like an assist in hockey. If you touch a guy,
yeah,
then you get credit for an assist.
It has to be. That's an awful lot of tackles. Big third down here for the Tigers. They've got to convert this.
Penalty flag. False start against the Tigers, and things go from bad to worse.
False start. Offense. 9 yards in play to that.
You couldn't tell from this angle, but I think it was one of the skilled players, which should never happen, mind you. These guys don't go off the quarterback's cadence. These receivers outside wide, they look at the football, and that starts their play. You don't care what the quarterback's barking, unless he's doing an audible, of course.
Big third down now, 3rd and 8. 3 receivers on the left side for Tyler Boyd.
Got to take care of the football down here.
Boyd runs up out of the pocket, 25-yard line, goes out of bounds up near the 30, had enough to pick up the first down, and smartly went out of bounds.
That's a smart play. Everybody's covered, run. That's been the most effective play all night, and we saw a lot of this in the first half where the play breaks down. Coverage is pretty good there by the Yeoman. He has enough speed to outrace the defense and gets that first down. I think that was crucial. Just to maintain possession, one, you don't want to give the ball back to the Yeoman to a decent field position, but to give confidence back to this offense.
8:50 remaining in the ball game. Tigers leading by 7. And Boyd will look for an opening through the middle. He'll pick up about 3 yards. Second down and 7 coming up for Daingerfield as the Tigers trying to wrap up a 3-year run that has been nothing short of amazing. Back-to-back 15-1 seasons, 2009 Division II 2A state champs, 2008 Division II 2A state champs.
Yeah, that's fallen into a special group of high school teams historically that have played in Texas. And you got to throw Lake Travis in there, winning their 4th consecutive state title here today.
Yeah, becoming the first team above Class 3A to win 4 in a row. And only the 3rd team to do so. They joined that Solana team that we talked about earlier from Class 2A that won 4 in a row in the early part of the aughts. And then that team from the 90s from Sealy that won 4 in a row in Class 3A. So Lake Travis becomes the first 4A team to do so. Winning today over Denton Ryan, Cowboys Stadium. Facing another 3rd down, the Tigers, 3rd and 3 from the 35-yard line, high snap. Boyd will keep it. He'll be tackled in the backfield short of that first down. Great job that time sniffing out the play for Cameron Yeo, Keaton Danio. And it brings up a 4th and 5.
That's just sound defense there by the Yeoman. Nobody overplayed their responsibilities. Everybody stayed home. And when you do that with a mobile quarterback, you take away his running lanes. That's great sound defense. Momentum still in favor here of the Yeoman.
Jeremy Godbolt will punt the ball away for Daingerfield. Derek Westbrook is back to receive it. And Westbrook takes the ball, 36-yard line, heads right, finds an opening, hits the corner, and he's off to the races. Watch out, Derek Westbrook cutting back to midfield, 20-yard line. Westbrook stays on his feet, tries to break out of the tackle, and finally going down at the 21-yard line.
Oh, wow.
A 36-yard punt, a 44-yard return for Derek Westbrook, and momentum swinging to the side of the Cameron Yeomen.
This is just a great individual effort, first and foremost. He got away with a block in the back there. But watch this lane create, and he has the speed to outrace the defense. Good blocking there. Now, there's only a few men left to be. Excellent block there at the right of the screen. But look at this individual effort, the willingness to keep going for his team and not be denied. Sets his offense up in excellent field position, almost in the red zone.
The O Nation is on its feet. Damian Kelly with the handoff, 15-yard line, inside the 10. Stays on his feet, down to the 5. Showing the heart, the desire for the Yeoman 16-yard pickup. Their fans are going crazy, and they're feeling the energy on the field.
Yeah, the energy is certainly there. And this offense is starting to feel it. Complacency will get you beat in a state championship. That's what the Tigers have found themselves in. Now you're starting to see these little runs that weren't as effective earlier, now taking a toll against this defense of the Tigers.
A timeout called. 6:20 remaining in the ball game. We'll take the break as well. It's Daingerfield 27, Cameron 20. Tigers and Yeoman fighting for the 2A Division I state championship. See the signs all over Vernon Newsom Stadium, Yo Nation. And the Yeoman trying to tie up this ball game with 6:20 left on the clock. They trail by a touchdown, 27-20. Jack Rhodes, first team All-State in Class 2A.
Man coverage on the outside.
First and goal from the 4-yard line. Rhodes looks to run. It goes down at the 4. No gain. Steve Edmond there to make the stop.
Yeah, that's tough there. Nobody blocked him. And it's bad enough when you have to try to block him. It's even worse when you miss him completely and let him have free run to the quarterback.
Second and goal. Three receivers on the left side for Jack Rhodes. Rhodes trying to get a look at the play. Referee was standing in the way. Rhodes throws, slant, incomplete. He was looking for Justin Sapp. Brings up third down.
He gets that pass down. That's a touchdown. Looks like Sapp had pretty good position. Watch this land. They've been awfully close. It was pretty good coverage there by Aaron Lewis, one of the safeties.
See if Rick Rhodes and his coaching staff have any tricks on third and goal. Rhodes stands in the pocket, flips one to Kelly. Kelly has the catch, stopped at the goal line, just shy of the end zone.
So close.
Devin Smith made the tackle, and now you've got fourth and goal from inches away.
Yeah, I think there's no question you got to go for it here. That's a pretty good pass and good effort there by Kelly. Didn't get in.
And now the Yeoman will call a timeout. Both teams have two timeouts left in the game. 5:10 remaining on the clock. Daingerfield 27, Cameron 20.
Now, I just don't think you take a chance here and put this ball in here. I think you say to your offensive linemen, you got Calstroon up there, you got Montez, you got Rangel. Those three guys in the center, the two guards, you tell them, hey, take us to the promised land and just do a quarterback sneak. I think you come out of your offense and do something uncharacteristic. It's the state championship. Nobody's worrying about how you scored. I think you send the quarterback under center, do a quarterback sneak, and get this touchdown.
Jack Rhodes is 6'3", 175 pounds. He's got the frame, but he's also facing a pretty big defense over on the other side.
It's going to be interesting to see. You don't have to go far, so this is my one little rant against the spread offense. I think this gets them in trouble a lot of times, but that's why we're up here in the booth.
Both sides fans on their feet. Fourth and goal from the 1 yard line, and Rhodes will line up at the shotgun. Kelly's in the backfield with him. Rhodes will try to run for it, and he is stopped. And you cannot do that. LD, your point is accentuated perfectly because you cannot line up in the shotgun and expect to gain what you need, even if it's just a few inches,
right,
to get into the end zone.
Yeah, you need a few inches, but your quarterback is 4 yards away from the line of scrimmage automatically. So right there, you've got to make up a difference of 4 yards just to get back to the line of scrimmage. That defense has been penetrating all afternoon. You needed something a little bit quicker. Quarterback Steak would have got that touchdown.
And that may be the defensive stand of the game for Daingerfield. 27-20, they lead. Shavion Hatton credited with the stop on Jack Rhodes, the TCU-bound lineman. Hand off to Lafayette, and Lafayette will pick up a yard, maybe two, up to the three.
Now, as much as I said that about Cameron Yell needing to get under center and just sneak it across the goal line, I think the same thing is true here for the Daingerfield offense. They don't need to be snapping a shotgun here. The snaps have been a little bit squirrely here in the second half. I think you need to put your quarterback, break your tradition of how you've run all season long, snap this ball, get a couple quarterback sneaks, punt this football if you can't get a first down.
Second down and nine. Boyd in his own end zone runs out of it. There's a penalty flag. Boyd had broken through, but it looks like there might be a face mask penalty coming against Cameron Yeo.
Well, Cameron Yeo still has to fight. If you can hold this offense down inside their own 10-yard line.
They have a false start. Offense, half the distance.
That's going to help you.
False start is the penalty, and that goes against Daingerfield.
Yeah, that's certainly going to help. And now all is not lost. You still have two timeouts, 4 minutes and 30 seconds remaining. Keep them down here. Maintain that field position. You've shown you can run a punt back.
Boy, something in the back of my mind just keeps telling me that the Tigers are just one play away from just sealing this game shut. Boyd throwing it down the near sideline. That might have been the play, but yep. Garris Garrett couldn't catch up to the pass. And you can see that Garrett is limited.
Yeah.
He's hurting. Mm-hmm. And if he was in perfect condition, he would have caught up to that ball.
Or at least laid out for it a little bit better than that and trying to go get the football. Because I'm like you, that could have been that one play that may just really set this thing off, and they can kind of salt it away, but still a lot of time. Not only is that an incompletion, it stops the clock.
Still a lot of time left. 4:09 on the clock, and both teams have two timeouts. And one of them gets used right here. 4:09 remaining in the game. Daingerfield leading 27-20.
Oh, I just don't get it sometimes. I know these coaches are great coaches and they've done it all season long, but it comes a point in time where you've got to break your tradition and not try to outcoach yourself a little bit too much here. Keep things simple.
Daingerfield might be having to rely on their defense one more time in order to win this ball game. Defense came up big on the last drive by Cameron Yeo, as Jack Rhodes got the ball down to the one-inch line to a pass to Damon Kelly, but then on fourth and goal could not make the first or make the end zone. And that has proven so far to be the difference in the ball game.
Well, they're not out of the woods here yet, though. They've got to move this ball, because even if they don't get this first down, if you throw another incompletion, that hurts you too, but if you cannot move this ball any further than where it is, you've got a punter that's going to have his heels in the back of the end zone.
Third and 10. Boyd rolls out. looks downfield, throws this one, a flip to Edmund. Two receivers were in the area. Neither one got the football. Steve Edmund was in the vicinity, as was Darren Terry. And now Tyler Boyd getting pulled away from one of the defenders for Cameron Yeo, Keaton Danio. As the two were talking a bit, fourth down and 10. And we will see Godbold come on to punt the ball away. He'll stand as close as you can to the edge of the end zone.
Well, we've seen how special teams can turn the tide of the game. Last week, did Geyer block the punt against Longview? That ultimately led to a win. Special team has been proving pretty effective here for the Yeomen.
Godbold needing a big punt. It lands at the 35-yard line. And on the return, Travion Sims works it inside the 25. A 33-yard punt, a 10-yard return. And you can't ask for anything more if you're Cameron Yeo. You have the ball inside Daingerfield territory with 3:51 on the clock. First down on the 24-yard line and two timeouts left.
Now, the defense bailed them out there. The defense did exactly what they're supposed to do. Special teams almost gets this ball in the red zone. Comes down to the offense again, trying to get this ball in the end zone.
Jack Rhodes, the senior quarterback. Flips one to Kelly. Kelly at the 25 goes out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Pickup of about a yard.
That's an outstanding play by Desmond Heath. Watch number 22 at the bottom of the screen. He doesn't get fooled by the action out the back door. He makes a play, enough of a play, to knock Damon Kelly out of bounds.
Second down and nine. Coach Rick Rhodes watching as his son leads the offense for the Yeomen.
And coverage once again by the Tigers. They are living and dying by this inside blitz.
Rhodes pump fake, now throws for the end zone. Jumping incomplete. Pass was intended for Westbrook, and he could not come down with it.
It looked like for a moment he did have that ball. Pretty good pass here by Rhodes. This is near perfect. I don't think you can put this ball anywhere else. And there, look at the separation that Westbrook has. And right at the very last, you saw a hand get up there and knock that pass down. That's Dejon Mims. That's a junior defensive back out there knocking it play down.
Huge third down play here. Third and nine from the 23-yard line. Direct snap to Kelly. Kelly breaks it left side but falls down at the 21. Edmund was right there. Only a 2-yard gain, fourth and seven coming up, and this could be the ball game for Cameron Yeo.
Now, this is where you need to have your best play on right now. Well, what's going to be one of your better plays? This is it.
Rhodes stays in the shotgun. Kelly is on his right.
Now they go into a two safety look, playing man coverage underneath. You got to have patience as a quarterback, and your line got to give you time.
On the slant, incomplete. The pass was intended for Zach Brashear, and the ball goes over on downs to the Daingerfield Tigers, who lead by seven.
And turn the ball over on downs to Daingerfield.
Both these teams have relied on their defense at points this year. Daingerfield has thrown four shutouts this season. Cameron Yeo, three. The Tigers giving up just 10.8 points a game. And that defense stands tall when they have to tonight to turn the ball over and give it back to their offense with a chance to put this game away under 3 minutes to play.
Now they have to think first downs. They have to think, hey, we've got to continue to move this football and move these chains. We can't have another three and out situation and give the ball back to the Yeoman's offense.
Boyd will run it on first down across the 25 to the 26-yard line. Picks up five. The Yeoman have two timeouts left.
Now you don't have to burn it right now. It's going to be under 2.5 minutes here in the game. But if you can get a stop here and get to third down, or you can stop him here and then burn it, still can maybe preserve a timeout for your offense. Maybe you can hold him.
High snap to Boyd. He'll run it up to the 30. About a yard shy of the first down. Third and one coming up. 10:34 left in the game at Cowboys Stadium between Trinity and Pearland, the Division I 5A championship. And the Oilers leading it 28-17. So Pearland looking for their first state championship as a 5A football club taking on the Beast from Euless Trinity and right now leading it by 11.
That's pretty impressive there. Well, history is going against the Trojans. They always win a state championship, it seems like, in odd years.
The odd years, yeah.
Might come back to bite them, and something that you always pointed out, they always have at least one loss going into the finals when they do win, and 15-0 this year.
And a try for a first-ever undefeated season. 27-20 here. Daingerfield leading Cameron Yeo. And what the Tigers need is a first down. Third and two coming up.
If you're on defense, the time to sell out right now to stop this run. I really think it's a hard time right now if you're Daingerfield to put this ball in the air. Now, that might be the genius call to do, is roll this quarterback out in the flat, give him a run pass option, catch this defense selling out to stop the run.
Steve Edmond lined up as a tight end, now goes in motion. Switches to the left side. Boyd will run that way, and he will not pick up the first down. He is a yard shy.
I don't even think he got back to the line of scrimmage.
First guy on the scene for Cameron Yeo is Ty Morgan. And now the timeout called, the last for Cameron Yeo. They have no timeouts left. A minute 57 left in the game. And Daingerfield facing fourth and one.
It's so funny, the start of this game, we thought it was going to be an offensive explosion. But to win a state championship, you've got to have some defense. And right now, we're seeing it by both teams. Both of these defenses, when they need a stop, they have come up and did exactly that.
Well, it seems that we've saved the best for last here in this final game of four this weekend for Vernon Newsom Stadium. Daingerfield and Cameron Yeo coming right down to the wire in front of a full house. A great weekend coming to a close and a great 2010 high school football season coming to a close as well tonight. Very privileged to be a part of it this year along with you, LD, working three state championship games this weekend. I will say that that gives me 22 state championship games that I've done play-by-play for since 1993. So I've been very blessed.
It's an honor to be with you. And I've got a long way to catch up with you, partner. But, hey, I'm enjoying this ride.
I'll take you with me as long as I can. So on fourth down and one, the Tigers will play defense one more time. Punt barely gets away by Godbolt. Takes a nice Tiger bounce. And it is picked up at the 29-yard line by the Yeoman, who immediately get hit. Derek Westbrook popped as soon as he picked the ball up.
That was awfully dangerous, too.
Yeah, that was very dangerous. That was playing with fire. But the destiny is in Cameron Yeo's hands as they trail by seven with a minute 44 left in the game. They do not have any timeouts.
Well, you're the senior quarterback. This is, you know, what you dream about when you're playing peewee football, to come up and grow up one day, lead your team to a state championship and have a chance late in the fourth quarter, have an opportunity to tie this game up. And if they may go for two, if they get in the end zone to win it outright, but this is what you live for.
Well, when his dad was the head coach in New Braunfels, little Jack Rhodes ran around in the halls talking about one day he was going to be a unicorn. He was going to lead him to a state championship. Well, it didn't work out in New Braunfels, but he's trying to get it done here at Cameron Yeo. Win one for himself, win one for his team, and win one for his dad. Second down and five coming up. hurry-up offense for the Yeomen. Rhodes in the shotgun. Looks downfield. Has time to throw. No pressure. Goes deep. Into double coverage. Ball is picked off. A penalty flag on the play. Pass was intercepted downfield. But there is a penalty marker on the play, and we'll see what the call is.
Wave it off. Come on!
Well, it was two Daingerfield defenders with one Yeoman receiver.
And this is a pass interference on the blue. 15 yards, previous spot, first down.
So instead of an interception, it is a pass interference penalty. A 15-yard mark off and life for the Yeoman.
Well, they're still breathing. They're still going, and they have to feel very fortunate about that. And we'll get a better look at it here. Just a heave downfield. Bashir's the intended receiver. Yeah, that's it right there. That's what they're going to call.
Rhodes' pass complete. The 25 down to the 23-yard line. Quinn Haynes, 32 yards. How about this?
Now they're playing that two-safety look, and the middle's going to be wide open every time. I'm really surprised they didn't take more of advantage of that earlier in the game, but that's a huge throw.
First down, the ball on the 22-yard line. Four receivers, two split. Either way, Rhodes has time to throw, goes for the end zone, has an open man. Is it a touchdown? No. He stepped out of bounds. Thomas Wren, who caught a touchdown in the first quarter of this ball game, almost had number two, but he could not stay inbounds.
Now, Reuben Mims, number 24, got beat earlier on that same play you talked about, Doug. He falls down there.
Foot was on the line.
Foot was on the line. That's a pretty good call there.
Boy, that's a tremendous call by our official that was watching the play, because he brought that ball in, and it was close. It was close.
Close.
Second and 10. Rhodes will try again. Pump fake. Now throws it to the end zone. Jump ball. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown. Zach Bashir. Unreal.
Kidding me. He looked like a center fielder trying to field a fly ball. That's what he looked like. Because that pass is not a good one, and watch him turn around. I hope we got a good replay of this. He gets behind the secondary. Watch this, Doug. He gets back there, turns one way, turns back around. Oh, man.
Wow.
That's excellent concentration there by Bashir.
What a catch, and what poise by Jack Rhodes to stand in the pocket as it was collapsing around him to get rid of that football. Now the very important extra point. Martin Rodriguez, it's good, and we've got a tie ball game. 47 seconds left in the game. 27-27 in the 2A Division I state championship.
Yeah, I don't want to be the bearer of bad news, but how about them kicking that field goal to go into halftime? They would be up 3 points here, or at least had a chance for it. No guarantee to make that. But you still have to really commend the efforts of the Yeoman to come back and just hang around, Doug, and finally get a chance to tie this thing up.
The Yeoman just would not go away. They were down by 14 at the half, and they have managed to hold Daingerfield scoreless in the second half of this ball game. 14 fourth quarter points to tie the game up.
And now that yardage gap is certainly kind of close. We saw Daingerfield pretty much run away with it in the yardage total. I mean, 355 to 127 at the halftime. Now it's 431 Daingerfield, 338 Yeoman. That's closing that gap a little bit, making the plays when you got to make them. We got ourselves a game here.
Tied up at 27. What a finish to this ball game.
I mean, it's been the tale of two different halves. It was the first half for Daingerfield.
And now Daingerfield thinking that the Yeoman might just try an onside kick.
No, I don't think you do that. Go ahead. You've been fortunate to get to this point. Go ahead and play the percentage. Kick the ball deep. You don't want to give this team a short field and beat you at the end of this game.
Got some good return men for Daingerfield back. Aaron Lewis and Edwin Mims. The kick is a short one, however, bobbled.
Oh.
And the Tigers will jump on it at the 28-yard line. And that was Dejon Mims, who almost turned into a goat right there on the field at Vernon Newsom Stadium.
Oh, boy. Big sigh of relief there on the Daingerfield sideline over here.
So we'll see if Tyler Boyd has any magic left with 44 seconds left in the game, or if we're going to overtime in the 2A Division I state championship.
Well, I know one player that's been quiet on this Daingerfield side offense, and that's number 10, Darren Terrell. It looked like he was going to be on pace for some ungodly number, but he has been relatively quiet, and that's a product of this offense shutting down, getting complacent, and not attacking the outside with the receivers.
Boyd looks at Terry, now goes the other way. Runs out of bounds at the 30-yard line with 37 seconds left on the clock.
I've just been impressed with the defense of the Yeoman. They made their adjustments at halftime. And this secondary has geared in and shut down these receivers and really taken advantage or taken away the deep play ball of the Tigers and just keeping everything under this umbrella. And they're saying, hey, okay, the quarterback's going to run on us a little bit. He's going to make some first down, but he's not going to beat us in this second half, and he hasn't.
Boyd, time to throw. Goes deep. Has a man down the middle of the field behind the defense. Caught.
My goodness.
Touchdown.
My goodness.
How about that? Kiaris Garrett. Tyler Boyd to Kiaris Garrett. A touchdown with 26 seconds left in this game.
Now, the one player that you can't let get behind the defense is that kid there, Kiaris Garrett.
The Tulsa commitment, Kiaris Garrett, somehow got behind two defenders and ran under that pass from Tyler Boyd.
Now, it's going to be a celebration infraction here, rightfully so. He had a lot of players coming out of that box and coming out onto the field.
And I know that's a penalty, but how do you not?
Yeah, that's more conduct after the kickoff. That's a 15-yard penalty. It'll be assessed from the kickoff.
But the score goes on the board, 33-27.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my. This is Judson and Midland from 2002, 33-32, one of the greatest games that I ever had a chance to call in the 5A Division I state championship at the Alamo Dome. Dustin Quinney hitting Andre Williams on a touchdown from 76 yards out with 17 seconds left in the game to give the Judson Rockets the win, and this one very much like it. Boyd has to improvise off the snap, and he will go down at the 10-yard line. But the damage has been done. The Tigers lead it by 6, 33-27, with 26 seconds left in the game. And, hey, this thing's not over yet.
No, it's not over, especially with the penalty. And yeah, this extra point is missed, too. But with that penalty, you got to look at where the Tigers are going to be kicking it from. And with the return man of the Yeoman, well, they can get this return up around midfield and still have a chance with the clock stopping with the possession there. Maybe take a couple shots here. Man, what a sequence.
It's always amazing. You look at a defense, you know what they have to do. They know what they have to do. But yet somehow it doesn't happen. And in a situation like that, the one thing that you could not do is let a receiver get behind your secondary. And yet Kiaris Garrett was able to do it and reel in that pass from Tyler Boyd. Let's take a look at the last two scores, Yo and Daingerfield. Jack Rhodes tying this ball game up with this pass into the end zone for Zach Brashears. That made it 27 all, but then Tyler Boyd stands in the pocket, delivers a deep bomb. Kiaris Garrett is there.
Yeah, that's a beautiful pass. Beautiful pass. Gets behind the defense, and I just didn't understand that one. You should have been playing a prevent defense. Who cares if they throw it underneath?
503 yards of offense for Daingerfield tonight. Over 300 for Cameron Yeo. Tyler Boyd, 291 yards passing, 4 touchdowns, 1 interception. He's also rushed for 148 yards in this game. Edmonds' kick will be taken by Westbrook. Fakes the reverse, 30-yard line, up to the 40, and he goes down there with 20 seconds left in the game. The Yeomen have no timeouts.
Now comes down to this again.
And can the Yeomen do what the Tigers did? Get a receiver behind the secondary.
Well, I, if I'm the defensive coach here for the Tigers, I'm yelling back to the secondary guys, get back. If anything, get back. Who cares if they make a completion underneath? Come up and make the tackle, but don't let anybody get behind you.
Hey. They can have 59 yards. They just can't have that 60th yard as they're standing on the 40-yard line. Pass. A dump off to Westbrook. He's dropped at the 40-yard line.
Oh, that doesn't get you anything.
No, and the Yeomen are trying to make their way up to the line of scrimmage for one last play.
Got
to
spike it.
And they spike it with 5 seconds left to go. Down to the final 5 seconds for the Yeomen. Daingerfield, their fans on their feet, they're bouncing on the sideline, they are anticipating a third consecutive state championship. The secondary is 40 yards off the line of scrimmage. Rhodes has to throw this one underneath. Now it's up to the Yeomen to improvise. They do, but it will go for naught. That is the final play of the game. The Daingerfield Tigers have made history again. 3-time defending state champions. The Tigers of Daingerfield, back-to-back-to-back state champions in Class 2A. And Tiger Nation celebrates for a third year in a row. Head coach Barry Bowman, 3 years, 3 state championships. What a mark.
That's impressive. And both of these teams are deservingly should be winners tonight. They laid it all out in line. Just came down to one big last play. I mean, that's all it was. I mean, both of these teams laid it on the line. Congratulations to the Tigers.
Daingerfield, a team stacked with talent. A lot of people thought this was exactly where they would be at the end of the year, and they have proven to live up to those expectations. 14-1, 2A Division I state champions. A tremendous season for the Yeomen of Cameron Yeo, as they end the year 14-1 as well. But it's Daingerfield who celebrates tonight as they win their third consecutive state title. And for Steve Edmond, who came into this program as a sophomore, he got a ring as a sophomore but didn't feel like he earned it in that sophomore season. Well, he's earned the last two, that's for sure. And he's one of the top players in the state of Texas who will go out with 3 rings as he celebrates on the field here at Vernon Newsom Stadium tonight. The final score, 33-27, Daingerfield over Cameron Yeo. We're back to wrap it up in a moment on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. Final score from Vernon Newsom Stadium in Mansfield, Daingerfield, 33. Cameron Yeo, 27 in the 2A Division I State Championship. The two teams met for a prayer in midfield. Great show of sportsmanship and class between the two programs. And it's the Daingerfield Tigers who celebrate tonight. Their quarterback, Tyler Boyd, was outstanding in this game. 11 of 21, 291 yards passing, four touchdowns, and 148 yards on the ground as he leads Daingerfield to their third consecutive state championship.
Yeah, just an incredible display there by Tyler Boyd. And what about this defense making some plays to give Tyler Boyd that last shot down the field to Ken Harris Garrett there? So, man, what a hats goes off to the Tigers for their third consecutive state championship.
And a great show by Cameron Yeo as well, as they were down by 14 for most of the second half. But a fourth quarter rally, 14 points, tied the ball game up before that final play from Tyler Boyd to Kiaris Garrett. 33-27, our final score. I want to thank you for watching on FoxSportsSouthwest.com. For our statistician, Robert Walton, and for Ladarin McClain, I'm Doug Anderson. It's been a great 2010 high school football season. We look forward to seeing you in 2011. Good night, everyone.